Each December, as the holiday season swings into full gear, people across the country reach into the back of their closets and rummage around for their iconic piece of holiday fashion, the ugly Christmas sweater. But where did this strange seasonal tradition start? Let's find out on today's episode of
Colossal Questions.
The intentionally ugly Christmas sweaters we wear today can trace their origins back to the original mass-produced Jingle Bell sweaters of the 1950s. But the ugly Christmas sweater faded into relative obscurity for 30 years or so, until the 1980s, when they first started to become really fashionable. For several years, these ornate, colorful Jingle Bell sweaters remained popular, even showing up in classic Christmas movies from the 80s. As the 90s rolled around, these silly, stuffy sweaters mostly went out of fashion, but in the early 2000s, they came back more popular than ever. No one can say for certain what reignited our fascination with the ugly Christmas sweater, but some sources trace the trend to another country which might have had the first ever ugly Christmas sweater party in Vancouver, Canada in 2002. Little did they know that their minor tongue-in-cheek event would evolve into such a cultural phenomenon. Over the years, the holiday trend has only gotten more popular, more ironic, and the sweaters have gotten crazier and crazier. Even high-end fashion brands are in on the trend, slapping giant price tags on intentionally ugly Christmas sweaters of their own. So, who actually invented the ugly Christmas sweater? Who's to say? Like so many other inventions, no one person masterminded it on their own. Instead, it's just a small, strange trend that took on a life of its own, slowly becoming a full-on modern Christmas trend. So, this year, find yourself the ugliest, stuffiest sweater you can find, probably in the back of your grandparents' closet, and enjoy one of the holiday season's truly strange traditions.